been a really special season from the standpoint of the consistency that our players have shown, the fight that they've shown. Our senior leaders have just taken charge of this football team on a number of occasions. Gone through some adversity, gone through some real highs, but maintain a consistent level of effort on the practice field and play on Saturdays. And as a coach, that's what you're looking for. From a personal standpoint, a lot of people that I'm really, really close to on this football team that we're certainly going to miss, those seniors. And then to see some youngsters step up too, some sophomores that have played really well. In a couple of cases, a couple of freshmen have stepped up and done awful well. So it's been a fun year that way.
As Philip Fulmer began his third season as head coach of the Tennessee Volunteers, he had many new faces, but there was one face he and Tennessee fans would recognize instantly. Peyton Manning adorned the cover of most preseason publications. He was terrific as a freshman, and the coaching staff was hoping he would be sensational as a sophomore. The Vols went up against East Carolina in the opening game on a gorgeous night for football at Neyland Stadium. It was September the 2nd, and the 1995 season was underway.
Over 95,000, and here they come, ladies and gentlemen, wherever you listen. It's football time in Tennessee.
The preseason reports were centered on defense, and the stoppers took the field first. Much of the hype centered on linebacker Craig King. In the season opener, he drew the starting assignment. Containing ECU's quarterback Marcus Crandall was the biggest challenge of the night, and King proved he was up for that challenge. With Crandall in check, the Tennessee offense took center stage. On the first possession of the new season, the Volunteers demonstrated a grinded-out approach with an 87-yard, 17-play, 8-minute drive. Sophomore receiver Marcus Nash reeled in a Peyton Manning strike for 17 yards along the way to the goal line, and it was back to crunch time then. Manning did the honors with a one-yard push behind Bubba Miller and his compatriots.
Offensive tackle. Graham, the standing tailback. Manning sneaking. Give him six. Touchdown, Tennessee!
There were big shoes to fill at the tailback position, but Jay Graham was ready to take firm control of the job. On this night, Graham slipped into the shoes for a nice fit. 144 yards and 26 carries. Speaking of shoes to fill, there was one more foot under scrutiny against East Carolina, that of place kicker Jeff Hall. And he too proved he was ready to kick off the new season. He accounted for 9 of Tennessee's points on the night with 2 field goals and 3 extra points. Speaking of points, DeRon Jenkins knows the best way to rack up 6 as he gets the ball back in Peyton Manning's hand. After East Carolina reached too deep into their bag of tricks, Jenkins gave the ball back to the UT offense. The offense did its part, and Tennessee went to the locker room leading the Pirates 17-7. In the second half, the Tennessee defense decided 7 points was plenty. The men in the orange shirts stifled the East Carolina offense with big plays from newcomers Leonard Little, Corey Gaines, and Jeff Coleman. The offense capped the night off with a 9-play, 62-yard scoring drive. Junior fullback Eric Lane dove into the end zone from the 1. The final score, Tennessee 27, East Carolina 7.
All right, JB.
Well, I think it's the team unity, how close we've been together, and how hard we worked in practice, each practice just getting stronger.
For Coach Philip Fulmer, the victory over the non-conference opponent, East Carolina, was a great way to start the season. But going into the first SEC game of the season against Georgia, Fulmer was sure his troops had something more to give.
Over your career, there are really important games. There are really, really important football games. This is one of those really, really important football games. If you want to be good, or if you want to be outstanding,
Today's the day you make your mind up. In your heart and your soul tonight needs to be left on that field. Empty the bucket. Empty the bucket tonight on that field.
The team wasn't alone in its commitment to Tennessee. On this night, 97,000 fans who lived for the experience of Tennessee football came to watch this classic SEC matchup between Tennessee and Georgia. Next year, Neyland Stadium expands to over 105,000 fans with the expansion of the stadium. But on this night against Georgia, it sounded that loud already. Containing Georgia's ground game was the focus of a fired-up Tennessee defense led by senior captain Scott Galyon. But the Dogs came for a fight on this night. Tennessee started off down 7-0. It didn't take long, however, for Peyton Manning and Joey Kent to preview what the rest of the season would look like offensively. In the drive, Peyton Manning hit Joey Kent for 45 yards and ran for 8 yards to tie the score at 7. On the other end, Georgia continued to press the ground game, but sophomore defensive end Leonard Little wouldn't have any of it. The first quarter ended 10-7, but slowly Tennessee's Peyton Manning began sharpening his aim by hitting receivers Marcus Nash for 12 and fellow sophomore Maurice Staley for 14. You might say the entire drive was rather sophomoric because the sophomore signal caller hit one of the most versatile sophomores of the bunch for a touchdown. Ronnie Pillow played receiver on Manning's 1-yard strike, and the Volunteers took a 14-10 lead. If offense keeps fans in the stands and defense wins games, it was time to start winning this one. Defensive tackle Shane Burton forced his way into the spotlight, as he did all season, and recorded his first sack of the year. Another who set himself up for a stellar year, Steve White, introduced himself to Georgia quarterback Mike Bobo on the next play, and another Bulldog drive was snuffed out. The first half was winding down, but in the SEC, teams have to make the most of their opportunities, and there was still time for Tennessee. After a clutch catch by Staley on 39, Jeff Hall stepped onto the field to attempt a 32-yard field goal. This extended Tennessee's advantage by 7 at halftime, as the Volunteers led the Bulldogs 17-10. But then in the third quarter, Tennessee found itself down 24-20. It would take more than that, though, to rattle Peyton Manning, who by the end of the season would be rated as one of the most efficient passers in the SEC, a league quickly known for producing the best quarterbacks in the nation. Finding Joey Kent was the first order of business for Mr. Manning. It was also the second order of business and the third order of business. Joey Kent proved to be the go-to guy in this drive, and in the third quarter, he did just that, catching a bullet from Manning on first and 10 from the 16-yard line. The key to the drive, and perhaps the key to the season's success, was the veteran offensive line anchored by Bubba Miller, Jeff Smith, and Jason Layman. The third quarter ended with Tennessee on top 27-24, and everyone was holding on for a wild ride in the fourth quarter. As with most wild rides, you get a little dizzy, and that was the case when Leonard Little met Torrin Kurtsey for a 2-yard loss. Georgia shook off the cobwebs long enough to score on a Dax Langley field goal, and that tied it at 27. At this point, something very rare happened, a Peyton Manning interception, one of only 4 on the season and over 300 pass attempts. Fortunately for Tennessee, the turnover led to no points for Georgia as Langley's 53-yard field goal attempt was no good. Now Peyton Manning had to lead Tennessee back down the field. A minute 30 to go, the score knotted at 27-all. Manning was back and assumed his position 65 yards away from victory, and Jay Graham was right beside him. Just when the Volunteers needed a big play, Graham came up with a huge one. Graham rambled 29 yards off the screen pass, but then just as importantly, a 10-yard gain on third and three set up Jeff Hall's moment in the big orange spotlight. Hall was the focus of 97,000 spectators, but he wasn't alone.
Well, it's a lot of pressure on young Jeff Hall, but that's what he's here for.
That's right, no question. They've set it up perfectly for him, got right in the middle of the field. It were a tie ball game, he can win it. Everybody's still here, nobody's left this ball game.
Well, it's down to this. It will be Jeff Hall attempting the field goal, 35 yards. Kick is up. Did he make it? The crowd tells you.
Good job!
Tennessee 30, Georgia 27. There go the fireworks. They just happen to have them over there. And so Tennessee leads by three. There's a volunteer injured, but Jeff Hall is ecstatic, as is all Bill Anderson of Franklin County.
I think of all of everywhere around this in this football stadium. This place is going crazy.
A lot of character by a lot of people. Defense sucking it up and stopping them. Offense taking that thing the last drive, getting us down there. And how about those rookie kickers and snappers? Yeah. How about Coach O'Brien?
That's really helped me out a lot, because last year we had a lot of, you know, I was inexperienced and the receivers were also. But this year, like I said, everybody stayed here this summer. We got our timing down, and everybody knows the offense a lot better now. So it's really helped us be a lot more productive.
Against the Florida Gators, the Volunteers set the tempo early. First, the defense shut down the fun and gun offense, three and out. And then Tennessee struck quickly. First offensive play, Joey Kent with 72 yards in this reception. That capped off the two-play, 81-yard scoring drive. With the tempo set, Tennessee went to dominate the first half. Fullback Chester Ford added seven to the score, and then senior DeRon Jenkins reeled in another interception. In the second quarter, Tennessee scored again on a quick drive. Three plays to the end zone with Marcus Nash. Tennessee found itself up 23-14 in the swamp, and senior end Steve White wanted more.
A lot of people to the line. Here comes the blitz on Werfel, stepping up looking. He's in trouble. He fumbles the football. It has been picked up by Tennessee at the 45, to the 40, to the 35, to the 30, to the 25, to the 20, to the 15, 10, 5. 4, 3, 2, 1, 6, 42 yards, Raymond Austin. And Tennessee turns a fumble into a fumble and a pickup and a touchdown, and how quickly things can change.
Tennessee went to the locker room leading 30-21 at halftime. If ever there was a half Vol fans and players wanted back, it was the second half of the Florida game. 30 minutes in Gainesville, all that stood between Tennessee and an undefeated regular season in 1995. Mistakes cost the Volunteers dearly on this day in Gainesville, and all that was left was to learn from them and move on.
Definitely, you know, I felt like there were two ways that our team could respond to the Florida game. You know, we could have laid down, you know, and basically wasted away the rest of the season, or we could have took it as a challenge to go out, you know, and showing everybody that wasn't indicative of how Tennessee is supposed to play. So, you know, we took it as a challenge. Everybody went out and just tried to get better every week, and you know, it showed in our play and everything. So, you hate to have a game like that against Florida, but you know, at least we used it as a learning experience.
Tennessee had little time to fret over Florida. The Mississippi State Bulldogs came calling the next week.
Tate again, looking for Moves. There he goes across the middle, pass instead thrown deep, intercepted Tennessee at the 45-yard line, and the man who makes the interception is DeRon Jenkins. Derek Tate has gone all the way at quarterback. He gives on a draw, and now he fakes the play action, and he is blasted from behind, and there is a fumble and a scramble for the ball at the 14-yard line. It has been recovered by Tennessee. State with five men on the defensive line. Copeland on the option is going to carry 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 6. Touchdown, Jermaine Copeland. Manning, the quarterback, two wideouts right. Man in motion from left to right. Manning being pursued from the backside into the end zone. Give him two. The catch is made by Marcus Nash in a crowd, but Tennessee marches downfield to score. Tennessee goes into a power eye. This is Graham diving. Give him six. Touchdown, Tennessee. Snap goes to Russ. Punt is blocked by Tennessee. Picked up by Tennessee at the 10, to the 5, to the 4, to the 3. He's lumbering at the 2. He's waddling at the 1. Touchdown, Shane Burton. The punt was blocked, and Burton at 268 pounds lumbers in to score, and Tennessee turns another big play into 6 points. The Volunteers lead 27 to nothing. Mark the ball just short of the 25-yard line of Mississippi State. Graham again trying to get to the outside. Stiff arms a man, runs through a tackle, has the ball at the 20, 15, 10, 5. Did he go all the way? Did he go out of bounds? He has scored. He has scored on a great run by Graham, and he just came out, and Bill Anderson absolutely took charge. State lines up with the shotgun. Back to throw is Tate being pressured, sacked. Who? It was Steve White exploding. Two tight ends in the football game. This is Manning giving to Lane. Cuts through the left side of the line. This is Lane at the 10, at the 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Give him six on a great run. Eric Lane. Tate for State. Looking for Moles. Here's the pass across the middle. Intercepted. Tennessee at the 35. To the 40. Staying on his feet to the 45. Still on his feet to the 50. Down to the 46-yard line. Scott Galyon. They've got a blocker on the left side as well in the person of Sartell. This will be Bryson trying for the touchdown. He made it. As the clock will count it down. 4, 3, 2, 1. The game is over. Tennessee beats Mississippi State.
The Cowboys of Oklahoma State came riding into town for a Tennessee homecoming. For the fifth straight time in 95, Tennessee scored in its first offensive possession. A key to the stat and a key to the Volunteer attack, Jay Graham and the seasoned offensive line. Together, they drew first blood as Graham plunged to pay dirt from the 1 yard line. Peyton Manning and the Tennessee offense really snapped to attention after the first quarter. Receiver Andy McCullough, another of Manning's amazing assortment of targets, added to the score just before the half was over. Did we say over? Junior strong safety Ray Austin proved it's never over. It was Austin's second interception of his career and gave the ball back to the offense with 18 seconds left in the second quarter. For Manning and receiver Joey Kent, it was a perfect opportunity to grab extra momentum against Oklahoma State. Then entered Jeff Hall and the needed momentum. No stranger to big kicks, he also proved he could hit a long one. Officially, 53 yards, but it easily could have been 63 yards. Hall was getting used to post-kick celebrations. But this game was really property of the Tennessee defense. Much maligned early in the season, now focused and out to prove they'd grown up and learned from their mistakes. And they did so with the little kid combination. Leonard Little and George Kidd combined for one of the three sacks on the day. Green players contributed as well. Ron Green might be inexperienced, but he proved talent can overcome any obstacle. When it was over, the defense posted its first shutout of the year, and Joey Kent added to his impressive numbers late. Tennessee 31, Oklahoma State nothing. And for Kent, more flashes of brilliance in what would prove to be a very brilliant year.
I didn't really imagine that I would even come close to that record at the beginning of the season. I think I joked with my position coach early in the season. I told him I wanted to catch 80 walls, and we kind of laughed. And I said I wanted over 1,000 yards. We kind of laughed, and you know, but I really came close to accomplishing those goals that I set at the beginning of the season. And so it just feels good to even be close to the records.
With a homecoming victory in the bag, Tennessee was hoping for bright days ahead. The problem was their first day back in conference play was in Fayetteville, Arkansas, home of the Razorbacks. Hog fans thought it was time for their 18th-ranked Razorbacks to join the upper echelon of the Southeastern Conference. The 10th-ranked Volunteers tried to set the tone early with a connection that would ring true all afternoon long, Manning to Kent.
And this is Manning off play action going deep, racing downfield. The Volunteers have a receiver there at the 15. 10, 5, give him 6. Touchdown, Joey Kent!
The play covered 55 yards, but rarely are games won in the SEC 7-0. So Tennessee knew he would need more points, especially after Arkansas answered with this 26-yard scamper from Madre Hill, and then this 52-yard thriller from quarterback Barry Lunny. Add a 36-yard field goal to the mix, and the Volunteers found themselves on the short end of a 17-7 Hog Wild contest. Coming into his own as the premier quarterback in the SEC, if not the country, Peyton Manning then took charge. Tennessee's first drive of the second quarter hinted at what was to come the rest of the afternoon. A 65-yard, 11-play drive that mixed the run and the pass equally, a Tennessee trademark. Manning's targets on the drive were sophomore Marcus Nash and, of course, Joey Kent, who kept the drive alive with this 13-yard reception on third down and 11. When third down came around again, Manning knew who was hot. Joey Kent again burned the Razorback secondary for a 29-yard touchdown and brought the score to within 3 points for the Volunteers. Arkansas's Madre Hill came into the game, ranking second in the conference in rushing. Stopping him was no easy feat, but the Tennessee defense was prepared for a battle in the trenches. They held Madre Hill to just 65 yards rushing on the day, and then the Hogs went airborne. It was apparent Arkansas was not going to give any momentum away. Tennessee would have to take it. The next two Tennessee drives were close to perfection. Manning was 11 of 12 for 111 yards. In drives of 73 and 78 yards, Manning displayed pinpoint passing to receivers Marcus Nash, true freshman Peerless Price, Joey Kent, and Maurice Staley. Some passes were so pinpoint, some would question whether they should have been thrown. As with the Arkansas defense, Manning had the answer.
I said, you know, sometimes you got to just be a player against a defense like this. They're going to do some things that aren't necessarily sound, that are trying to put you into a bad play. So it's a matter, like one time through Maurice, he kind of converted the route. You know, like I said, you don't want to do it too often, but when time comes to be a player, you have to be one sometimes.
Tennessee had recaptured the lead 28-24. The second half tempo in this battle was set by the defense, specifically the defensive line. Two sacks in the first series of the second half. First, it was Leonard Little, and then two plays later, Steve White added to his building total with a blast to quarterback Barry Lunny. From there, it was all Tennessee. The offense started things off with a 77-yard, 16-play drive as Tennessee led it 35-24. Now with the upper hand, Tennessee looked to control the clock. One sure way to get control, Jay Graham. On this day, he racked up 130 yards rushing, his fifth 100-yard rushing day of the season. He also demonstrated his pass-catching ability. But with Graham, it's what he does after the catch that matters. But the only thing that really matters is hitting pay dirt, and Graham scampered in for another of his three touchdowns on this day. Arkansas managed another score to make things interesting, but after freshman Jonathan Brown forced an Arkansas fumble, that was converted 6 plays later into a touchdown, and Tennessee had won the game. On the day, the offense totaled 521 yards. Peyton Manning tied a school record with 35 completions. Philip Fulmer had to take his hat off to the savvy sophomore from the Bayou. Next stop, Birmingham, Alabama. With the symbol of German engineering hovering over Legion Field, The Volunteers hit high gear with a first quarter performance better suited for the Autobahn.
There's a tight end for the Vols to the right side. This will be Manning. Back to throw. Across the middle. Pass complete. Ball down at the 35, to the 40, to the 45, to the 50, to the 45, to the 40, to the 35, 30, 25, 20, 15, 10, 5. What did he do? All he did was score. Joey Kent. Touchdown on play number one.
One play, 80 yards, 14 seconds, 7 points. Tennessee was able to set the tempo, and they wouldn't stop there. The last time in Birmingham, it was close, ending in a 17-17 deadlock. But it was quickly apparent the Volunteers weren't settling for any ties this year. After stopping the Tide in 5 plays, the defense gave the ball back to the offense and Peyton Manning. This time, Tennessee showed it could score equally on a long drive. Starting at the Tennessee 7, the Volunteers ran out of trouble, and then with significant room to work, Manning threw 5 straight passes for 5 straight completions. At the 25, Marcus Nash heard his number called and rose to the occasion.
Here's the pressure. Here's Manning down into the end zone. That touchdown pass is caught! I knew he had it. Marcus Nash, touchdown, they got it.
Realizing the opportunity to put Alabama away early, Leonard Little and Bill Duff combined to turn the ball back over to the offense with only 24 yards to go. Despite calling a handoff to Jay Graham in the huddle, Manning and the Tennessee coaches had other plans for this play.
No, it's Manning on the naked handoff, reverse to the left side. Nobody even knows who's got the ball except Peyton Manning. He's got the ball, and where is he? In the end zone for 6.
1 yard to the touchdown.
Everybody went with Graham through the right side, and Manning just played it so brilliantly, gave no indication, Bill.
The first quarter ended with Tennessee leading 21-0, and the Volunteer fans sensed more to come. With 3:01 remaining in the half, Tennessee went to work. After hitting Maurice Staley for another 13-yard pass, Peyton Manning found Marcus Nash on this beautiful route.
First down and 10. Long count. He's changing the play. The play clock is down to 8 seconds. Manning for Tennessee, being pressured, throws the ball across the middle, complete. Ball down at the 15, at the 5, at the 4, at the 3, at the 2, at the 1. Give him 6. Touchdown, Marcus Nash. Manning stood in there. They were coming after him. He stood there, he ripped that football, Nash pulled her down, and rides in to score, and Tennessee goes on a brilliant drive.
Yeah, it looked like that was almost the same pattern that Joey Kent scored on the opening play, John, inside there. He was getting really strong pressure coming from the backside. I thought he might get to him before he could.
At the half, it was Tennessee 28, Alabama 7. Peyton Manning was 13 of 20 for 253 yards. But as every Volunteer fan, player, and coach knows, there are 2 halves to any Tennessee-Alabama football game, and the Volunteers still had work to do. The defense set the tempo on Alabama's opening possession of the second half. Scott Galyon recorded a sack on Freddie Kitchens. Facing 2nd and 21, the Tide went to the air, just what Tennessee's Terry Fair was hoping for. No points were scored on the ensuing drive, but pinning the Tide at its own 3-yard line looked just as good. The Tide scored on a 97-yard drive, but on the bright side for Tennessee, that drive ate up almost 6 minutes of the clock. That clock was becoming more and more precious for the Tide. But with that Alabama drive, it seemed like the Tide had seized the momentum in this game. Enter Jay Graham.
Alabama with the white hash mark. This is Manning. Crowd deafening. Hand off Graham. Comes to the near side at the corner. 25-30. Outside 35-40. 45-50. 45-40. 35-30. 25-20. 15. 10. 5. Yes. He went all the way. Is there a marker in the field? There is no marker on the field. Touchdown, Tennessee! Wow. 75 yards. Graham gets to the...
Seventy-five yards in just 21 seconds, and the momentum belonged to Tennessee once again. If there was ever any doubt, the defense erased that. Leonard Little logged another sack, one of six on the night for the defense. And now with the ball back and plenty of confidence, it was time for some razzle-dazzle. The touchdown derby was over for Tennessee, but Jeff Hall still had points to add, making the score 38-14. After a DeRon Jenkins interception, it was time to notch the score at 41-14. The next defensive series was the exclamation point on this marvelous night for Tennessee. First, Shane Burton nailed Kitchens for a sack, and then Anthony Hampton found the tied quarterback for another loss. Ray Austin announced later, "If you can't stand the heat, get out, Kitchens," and Freddie left the game for his defense to mop it up. The ensuing celebration was what you would expect. Jubilation by the fans and the players and the coaches. Truly a memorable night in Birmingham at last.
The clock is counting, and Tennessee goes racing, the entire team racing over in front of the volunteer fans at the north end, northeast corner of the field as the volunteers have come to Birmingham, and Tennessee will go home with a 41-14 victory.
At last. Oh, and then the spell was cast.
the best moment of the season, I'd have to say when we beat Alabama and we went over to the fans after the game, you know. I think that was the best moment of this whole season.
The Alabama game, you know, the end of the game, just the feeling that it gave, you know, this was the first time we've beaten Alabama since I've been here, since a lot of people have been here, actually. And, you know, it was just such a great feeling. You know, we had a big fan following at the game and everything, and after the game went over there and they congratulated us and everything, it was a feeling that lasted probably maybe a whole week. You know, it was just a great feeling. It's hard to describe.
The party was great while it lasted, but for the Tennessee Volunteers, that was exactly one day. Then it was time to focus on the South Carolina Gamecocks and quarterback Steve Tannehill. It was clear in the week leading up to the battle that South Carolina was a very dangerous team. Despite a slow start on Tannehill's opening drive, the defense finished strong with this great hit on the goal line, keeping Tannehill out, and then seemingly forcing the Gamecocks to settle for a field goal. But then Leonard Little and Tyrone Hines made the Gamecocks settle for being down 7. Little breaks through to block the kick. Tyrone Hines scoops it up and heads for the goal line. The next possession for the Gamecocks proved Tannehill had a little problem. Leonard Little was in the signal caller's face all day, and this series was just a preview of things to come. On 4th and 9 at the Tennessee 27, Tannehill took the first of his many sacks. On this day, though, it took Tennessee's offense a little bit of time to get on track. What a difference a quarter makes. After defensive back Ray Austin set the tone of the quarter, Manning directed a workmanlike drive of 6 plays and 41 yards. In the next drive, the offense seemed to pick up steam. Graham did his part by gaining 16 yards after first looking to be in trouble. Eric Lane proved his versatility, catching a pass out of the backfield for 15. And Greg Kyler continued his contributions as he grabbed another one for 15 yards. Joey Kent would do the rest.
He is the lone running back behind Peyton Manning. South Carolina with 4 men to rush. Manning back to throw. Here comes the pressure. Here's Manning stepping up. Dumps the pass out there. Complete to Joey Kent. Kent at the 25, 20, 15, 10, 5. He has scored. Touchdown, Tennessee. Manning picked up Kent. Kent picked up the ball, and then Kent goes untouched downfield, and the Volunteers are on the scoreboard 20-0.
The Gamecocks answered and set the score at 21-7 with 2:08 remaining in the half. First glance, didn't seem like 2:08 was a lot of time. It proved to be plenty for Tennessee. First, new return specialist Terry Fair returned the kickoff 46 yards. 3 plays into the drive, Mr. Dependable Joey Kent found a seam and 6 points. The score was 28-7 with 1:10 to go in the half and one more score to go. With 20 seconds to go, Steve Tannehill dropped back to pass and found the hands of Shane Burton waiting. In a truly remarkable play, Burton retrieved the ball and came up with the interception. After a 24-yard strike to Marcus Nash, Tennessee was set for a Jeff Hall field goal. Or were they?
Holding will be Price. Snapping is Ingram. It will be a 32-yard field goal try with 4 seconds to go in the first half of the game. It will be running the ball instead. This is Price breaking a tackle. This is Price. He has the ball at the 15, 10, 5. Ladies and gentlemen, he has scored a Tennessee touchdown. The Volunteers come with a fake field goal, and Jay Price dances into the end zone. He's a happy player, as are his compatriots, and Tennessee's Jeff Hall and Jason Price embrace one another as the Volunteers tack on a touchdown.
In the second half, Leonard Little continued to get to know Steve Tannehill. With Carolina stalled, Terry Fair continued his impressive return duties, but the offense faltered, at least temporarily. A Jeff Hall field goal was blocked, but South Carolina gave the ball right back to Tennessee's Billy Barron, who gave it to Tyrone Hines, who gave it back to Peyton Manning, who gave it to Jay Graham. Graham kept it long enough to ramble 17 yards on a screen with Smith, Miller, and Poole in front, and Tennessee led it 42-7. After South Carolina scored in its next possession, Jay Graham pulled a play reminiscent of the Alabama game, just when USC thought they had some momentum built up from the score.
Flankers left and right. Manning for Tennessee gives to Graham. Popping up the middle, big hole. Graham to the 35, to the 40, to the 45, to the 50, to the 45, 40, 35, 30, 25, 20, 15, 10, 5. Touchdown, 67 yards, Jay Graham.
Tennessee 49, Carolina 14. The offense and the defense each had one more big play up their sleeves. Shane Burton once again got his hands on a Tannehill pass. This time it was reeled in by freshman Al Wilson. Eight plays and 44 yards later, tight end Scott Pfeiffer set the Tennessee score at 56, and it was only the third quarter. For Tennessee, everybody played in the fourth quarter. For the day, the Volunteers racked up 437 yards total offense and allowed only 291 in defense, most of which came in the fourth quarter. Quarterback Peyton Manning set a three-game streak of throwing 71 completions on 95 attempts for 900 yards and 11 touchdowns.
Joey's kind of quiet. Is he off the field? Does he turn it up on the field? I mean, does he talk to you at the huddle, say, I'm open?
Well, he complains a lot in the huddle. He really expects the ball every play. And so, as being the quarterback, I feel I'm a year older. I can kind of settle him down a little bit. But, when the game's on the line, Joey's going to be open. He's going to be one of the guys I'm looking for because he's our most experienced receiver and really made a lot of big plays for us this year.
No, to set the record straight, I think he complains more than I do. When we drop a ball or when something goes wrong, he always looks at us and he gives us the eye, and we know that we need to tighten up whatever we need to do. But I think he complains more than I do, to set the record straight.
But I'm sure you come back if you're open, though.
Yeah, if I'm open, I let him know. I mean, the other receivers, they let him know also.
The first great thing, November. The second great thing, Southern Miss. Tennessee entered November 1995 with a 37-1 win streak for the month, dating back to 1985. They hadn't played Southern Miss since beating the Golden Eagles 56-0 in 1950. 1995 score would be equally dominating. The word for the day, defense. On Southern Miss's first offensive series, it was three and out, and it wouldn't get any easier the rest of the day. The next series, also three and out. Then the next series, an interception by Ray Austin. And then the next series, an interception by Terry Fair. You get the idea, Tennessee's defense was great. Tennessee's unstoppable offense was at it again. The Volunteers didn't slow down at all in this game. Peyton Manning led the Volunteers to touchdown after touchdown, 42 points on the day. Southern Miss returned 10 starters on defense, but they weren't going to give up points easily, unless it was scored by special teams. Tennessee's Ray Austin announced his presence again. Sophomore Mark Levine reaped the award, and Tennessee was up 21-0. Second half, different quarter, same story. After a beautiful throw and catch by Manning and Kent, Jay Graham found the checkerboard again.
Three, two, one, touchdown, Jay Graham!
Two plays later, Jesse Sanders, quickly turning into a big play specialist, came up with another Tennessee interception. Manning and redshirt freshman Dustin Moore wasted little time capitalizing.
Back to throw. Pass complete. Juggle. Caught. 10, 5. Touchdown, Dustin Moore!
Joey Kent's score late in the third quarter was the last of the day for Tennessee. The fourth quarter was little more than a scrimmage for the future Vol Stars. On the day, The defense allowed only 142 yards and, incredibly, allowed only 3 yards rushing all day. Along the way, there were 4 sacks from the defense and 4 interceptions. Peyton Manning's record of the week? Well, he set the Tennessee mark for passes without an interception at 123 and counting.
Just on the defense side of the ball, just our work ethic in practice. We go out every day, and Coach Chavis is somebody that really gets ready for practice, gets us prepared for games. But I think the most important thing is just our work ethic, the way we go out on the practice field and push each other to get better, and just concentrate on that every day when we go out. I mean, for me, since I've been here my 4 years, this has been the best defense I've played on, as far as practice habits and going into the game and using what you've learned during the week and applying it in the game.
You've heard it before, when two old rivals meet, you can throw the records, the rankings, and the point spreads right out the window. For the Kentucky Wildcats, that window was one of opportunity to make their season. But they couldn't pull it off against a dominating Tennessee team. Tennessee got on the board first with a Jeff Hall field goal, but that advantage didn't last. Kentucky countered with 10 points, and suddenly the Wildcats had their sights set on the famed beer barrel, the trophy that has remained in Knoxville for over a decade. The second quarter was much like the first. Kentucky answered a Jeff Hall field goal with a touchdown and seemed to be gaining momentum on the Volunteers. But Hall continued to make his presence felt, ending the half with a 50-yard boot that made the score 17-9 in favor of the Wildcats. It was the only time all season the Volunteers were down at halftime. If Tennessee fans were amazed to be down at 8 at halftime, they'd even be more shocked in the first minute of the second half. Mo Williams put the Cats ahead 24-9 on this 31-yard gallop. And then it was officially time for Tennessee to suck it up and go play. Jeff Hall did his part again. He'd made his 4th field goal on the day. Next, Peyton Manning did the honors with his pass to Marcus Nash to get to the 1-yard line. And then he did the rest. In a traditional game, you should count on traditions. And for Tennessee, that means fast wide receivers. Joey Kent grabbed a 70-yard touchdown pass and his place in history with the catch. He passed former Volunteer Thomas Wood's single-season receiving mark of 58 catches, setting the new mark at 60 and counting. Suddenly, Tennessee was back on top of the Wildcats, 27-24.
I really didn't expect it because it's been so many great receivers that's been here through the past. Willie Gault, Alvin Harper, Carl Pickens, Corey Fleming. It's been a number of guys that's in the NFL right now, and they're really performing well. And just me to be in that same picture, it's really a humble experience, but I really feel proud about my accomplishments.
In the SEC, nothing lasts forever, and that included this lead. Thanks to the heroic efforts of Kentucky's young quarterback, Billy Jack Haskins, Tennessee was behind again, but not for long. In games like this, when an SEC team needs a running game, that's just what Tennessee has. Jay Graham rambled on the ensuing series as he had all day and helped set up the last touchdown of the day. Freshman wide receiver Greg Kuyler's first career touchdown came on this 9-yard pass from Peyton Manning. The scoring summary is not the whole story this day, however. For the rest of the story, let's go to Leonard Little and company. On the day, Little recorded 10 tackles and 2 sacks. The defense allowed 175 yards rushing, but more importantly, when it was all said and done, Tennessee outscored the Wildcats 34-31. The Tennessee Volunteers closed out the regular season November the 25th against Vanderbilt. Tennessee fans said goodbye to 16 special seniors, a senior class that had won 35 games. wins in exciting fashion against the best teams in the nation. This senior class will go to 4 bowl games, and they've now won 36 games during their Tennessee career. It's always tough to say goodbye, especially to this group, many who have been starting and playing since their freshman season.
I know it's going to be emotional for me. I know it may not be for other people, but coming from a small town here, it's always been my dream to come here and play at Tennessee, and I did, and I've had a really good career, and I just hate to see it come to an end.
The Alabama game of this year stands out, finally coming through and beating them and ending the streak or whatever you want to call it, and just having a big game and playing well all the way around.
Probably the, most enjoyable 3 years I've ever had, I love Tennessee and I love playing for Tennessee, and, I have a lot of friends here, a lot of guys on the team are my friends. Hopefully after I get out of Tennessee, it's something I can look back and, call them up 5-6 years from now, and, get together.
I felt like that I've, experienced everything. I hadn't let any of it pass me by. Beating Alabama, whooping Alabama this year, that's always going to stand out in my mind. That's probably, the greatest thing since I've been here, and I'm just glad it happened my senior year.
First thing that I remember is running through the tee when I was a freshman there at Tennessee, the 95,000+ people screaming and yelling. It's a feeling that you can't describe in words. You just got to experience it. I had hurt my leg. I had a lot of support after the injury. I had a lot of mail, some phone calls from different people. So, it was unfortunate it happened, but, the people of Tennessee made me feel like I was still a part of the Tennessee family.
These 16 Tennessee seniors will take with them memories of big wins and big games. More importantly, friendships that will last a lifetime. Tennessee went into this battle with Vanderbilt knowing it was 60 minutes away from a 10-1 season, but also knowing Vanderbilt would give maximum effort in this in-state battle. It would take every bit of those 60 minutes to pull off a great finish to a great season.
Tennessee second down and 8 at the Vanderbilt 48-yard line. The Commodores lead. Pitch will go to Graham. Needs a block at the corner. Turns up field 45. Breaks 40. Has the ball 35. Has the ball 30. Stays on his feet as he roars out of the bounds at the 27-yard line. A superlative run by Jay Graham, leading 7-0. Vandy with the best football. Back to throw. This will be Allen, sacked by Steve White at the 41-yard line. He really came after him. This will be Allen giving off to Johnson. Dumped for a loss at the 39-yard line. Leonard Little from right to left. Tennessee reacts in the secondary as they run back to the near side. Jermaine Johnson, and penetrating and diving through is Scott Galyon on a blitz, and he knocks down Johnson for a loss. Tennessee comes in the I formation. And this will be Manning off play action. Pass pulled out and pulled down at the 25 to the 30. To the 35, still on his feet to the 40-yard line is Eric Lane. So to this point, he's the all-time single-season leading rusher. This is Graham again through the left side. This is Graham. He has the ball at the 5. He is turning at the 3. He is battling at the 2. He is down at the 1. Tennessee in a power eye set to the right. Graham is the tailback. This will be the fullback diving. Give him 6. Touchdown, Chester Ford. Vandy with Johnson at tailback. And this will be Allen out to throw. Allen is sacked all the way back down at the 5-yard line by Jeff Coleman. Vandy, third down 8. Tennessee into a 5-man front. Vanderbilt gives the ball to Johnson, trying the near side. No. Tennessee swarms him. Leonard Little would have nothing of that. Vanderbilt in the I formation, flankers left and right. Allen off play action, back to throw, being pursued. Allen will run, Allen will be dumped, sacked by Little. Leonard Little knocks him down at the 46-yard line as Tennessee had the 3 deep receivers well covered. The quarterback, Allen, gives it off, and this is Johnson, and here is Leonard Little, and he throws him for a loss of 5 yards like a shot. Fourth quarter of the game. The Volunteers with Manning rolling to the near side, looking to throw across the middle, complete. Pull down at the 40 to the 45 to the 50. This will be Marcus Nash moving it down with his first catch in the football game. Manning fading to throw. Screen pulled down at the 50. This is Graham outside 45-40, 35-30. Knocked out of bounds as he moves it down to the 27-yard line. This is Manning giving to Graham. Graham up the middle. This is Graham. Graham at the 15. Graham at the 10. Graham explodes downfield to the 6-yard line. With the power eye set to the right side, Vanderbilt into a 6-man front. Everybody up tight. This is Graham getting to the outside. He lowers his head. He booms. He turns. He drives. He fights. He scores. Jay Graham said, "I will not be denied." He was not denied.
It was a record-breaking season for Tennessee individually. Peyton Manning set a single-season passing mark for yards, 2,954. A single-season record of 380 attempts, and more importantly, 244 completions. And also, his completion percentage of 64% also set a new school mark. Jay Graham set a single-season rushing record with 1,438 yards. Also, Graham had 10 100-yard rushing games. That's also a new single-season record for Tennessee. Joey Kent becomes the first volunteer receiver to gain more than 1,000 yards in a single season. Also, his 69 catches in a single season set a new Tennessee mark.
You know, individual records are part of football sometimes, but I owe all the credit to my offensive line, and Jay Graham's had a great year, and defense has been getting the ball for us a lot recently, and of course, we have great receivers here at Tennessee, so it's really more team records that that contribute to the individual records I might achieve.
I mean, I don't know if I consider myself the best. You know, I still have a lot to learn, but I mean, it means a lot to me to have gotten as many yards as I have, and just working as hard as I have this whole season. You know, it's meant a lot to me, and I just know I have to, I can't let up. I just have to get better and better, you know, going into the off season, into the next season.
It was another electrifying season for the Tennessee Volunteers. High scoring offense, hard hitting defense, come from behind heart thumping victories and offensive explosions. For only the 11th time in 100 years of Tennessee football did a volunteer team finish with at least 10 victories. Tennessee Football 95, a season for special players who proved they were worthy of wearing the orange.